Hey everybody, so I'm back to film my September favorites. I noticed everyone was posting theirs because it's October now and I'm a little behind. So let's just get into everything. I don't have a bunch of favorites this month. I really just don't. First and foremost, this sugar lip treatment. This comes in the Sephora Happy Birthday gift, or that's like the current gift they have. So if you go to Sephora like near your birthday or make a purchase, I guess the month of your birthday or within a couple weeks of your birthday, you get this. Oh, hold on. Yeah, so you get these two together. I mean, shit, you guys. It comes in a little box. This one is the tinted one, which is the rose. I have a little lip color on my finger. Please ignore that. It's got a lot of OCC lip tar all over my finger. That's what I'm wearing right now. I haven't used this, but that's what it looks like. I guess it just gives like a little red tint to your lips. Haven't used it at all. I wasn't impressed with one of their other tinted lip treatments, so I didn't care for using it. But the clear one, it's kind of just like a lip balm. And I love lip balms. This one, it has such like a fruity scent. It's hard to describe what type of fruit, but it's really nice. Mine is all ugly because it broke. Was that all? Yeah, that's how much I have left. I've used so much of it. It's ridiculous. It broke and then I just kind of smushed it back together and put it into the tube, and then it kind of tried to look a little better. I just didn't really care for fixing it properly, but I've been using this just all month as my lip balm. This has been my go-to lip balm. It's so cute and tiny. So tiny. Just throw it with you. It looks really nice. Chic. Great for a free little gift from Sephora. I've been enjoying it. It keeps my lips nice and moist. I do have to reapply a couple times to it with any lip balm. It's kind of like that. And why is my jacket open? All flopping around like a bat. Okay, better. So the next favorite is my Makeup Forever Matte Velvet Foundation. I have not done a review on this yet. I did record it once, but I'm not sure if I like how it came out, so I might re-record it. I do have the Kat Von D one recorded, so that one will be coming up beforehand for all those waiting for my Kat Von D foundation review. But this is my newer one. I've been wanting to try it. I am not wearing it today. I wore it in a couple of my recent videos, though. It's cheaper than the Makeup Forever HD foundation. It's, I think, like $34, $36. I think it's $36. And it has, like, a really nice, precise, like, squeeze tube thing going on. Like, you can get the exact amount that you need. It's really good for travel, so I'm probably going to take this when I go to LA in 2 weeks, which I'll talk about a little bit more at the end of this video. Next, a non-beauty-related favorite. You guys know I throw these in on occasion. Aleve. This is a giant bottle of Aleve from Costco. It has 320 pills or whatever, you know, you want to call them. Call them caplets on the bottle, but this is huge. Usually Aleve is like this tiny, like half of the size. It's half in every sort of dimension, but we got the big Costco size because we all in this house like Aleve for cramp relief. You know, those cramps, the ones you get during, this is really loud, that time of the month, you know. Those. I sadly am one of those girls who are burdened with the painful cramps during that time of the month. But one pill of Aleve, good. Good till the next month. Perfectly fine. And it's really tiny too. I really hate pills that are really huge. You know. These are super tiny. Let's see if you guys can even see it. Look how tiny it is. Very tiny. Works better than ibuprofen or, you know, Advil, which is basically the same thing, and Tylenol, which is not the same thing. But it works better than all of those. I support Aleve fully. It works better than Midol, too. I used to use Midol in high school. Aleve, much better. Another favorite, my BH120 palette. This is the third edition. I think they have, like, four now. Four editions? I don't know. I know this isn't the last edition, though. But this is my favorite. I've owned the second and the third edition, but the third is the one I always reach for. It has a nice range of pastel type of colors, kind of soft, softer than the other palettes. Other palettes are more like wham, neon. I like this one a little more. And the bottom looks like this. And it has like, you know, the browns, the blues, the silvers. I've been really in love with using this brown specifically for some reason the whole month. I don't know why. This brown and this little purplish brown burgundy color, I've been loving those two. I've used this in a tutorial in the past. I think it was like my tropical colored eyes or something, which I will try to link off. I should do more tutorials using this. This is a really good palette for its price. I want to say it's like on sale for like $15 right now or something like that. I don't even know. It's really affordable. It's under $30. Really good price for someone who just needs a lot of shadows or a big variety of shadows. I like BH's palettes a little bit more than Coastal Scents. Just being honest, I do. It the shadows are bigger, you get more for your money, and the quality is a little bit better to me. Like, it's almost neck and neck, but I like the BH ones more. Like, I would buy the BH over and over rather than buying Coastal Scents. Since I got BH palettes, I haven't really touched any of my Coastal Scents. I sold most of them on blog sales in the past. I think I used it in my Getting Ready With Me 4 video. Look like I said 3. Next is this little pencil thingy. I've never spoken about it on my channel, which is surprising because I've had it for almost a year now. It's been over a year. I've had it for a while. This is the NYX Eyebrow Shaper. I've already sharpened it, I think, so it's smaller. Yeah, it's shorter than it usually would be. The stopper on the cap stops it right here, so it can't reach fully, but you can see, like, it used to be up to here, I think. This is a wax pencil. I don't know the price right now. It's a little dirty because I used it today. Usually I just try to wipe it off on a napkin. But if you're the type who needs wax for your eyebrows, I typically use it now because I have, like, these random stray hairs that like to stick down. And even if you trim them, you know, they still want to point down. It's the way they grow. So just use it a little bit. You can use it before you fill your eyebrows in, of course. I just tend to use it after. Just a little. I don't like to use too much. If I use too much beforehand, it looks really weird after I put the powder on top. It looks almost too clean. But I like them. It helps a lot. So if you need a clear wax in something, like, very easy to take with you or it's easy to use, this would be perfect. It is, like, the same size as the NYX Jumbo Pencil, so you need a sharpener that can sharpen that. Next is a favorite nail polish of the month. I mentioned it on my Instagram recently. I don't have it on my nails anymore. I took all my nail polish off, so they're bare. I know. But this is by Essie, and it is a very beautiful gray. It's called Armed and Ready, and I picked this up when I was in LA, like, last May or June. Let me show you guys up close if you can see. It's so gorgeous. Can you see the reflection? It has, like, a goldy green reflection, but it's a beautiful gray. I love it. I love it more than Chinchilla. Yes, you heard that. I used to love Essie's Chinchilla like crazy, and I haven't touched it since I bought this. So I am going to be wearing this a lot during fall. It is a beautiful, beautiful color. Last but not least, two favorite lip colors of the month. They're new. I recently wore them in videos, one being Ruby Woo, the Rope by MAC, and it is a beautiful red. Everyone loves Ruby Woo on YouTube. I haven't met a YouTuber who doesn't love it. It's supposed to be, like, the perfect universal blue tone red that looks great on everybody. And it's a matte. And I will show you guys right here. It's, like, a very in-your-face red, but at the same time, it's beautiful. It's very, very matte. Like, it's a little hard to put on because it's matte. It doesn't glide super well if you're not used to it, but it's so beautiful on the lips. It's very in-your-face, but for the season, it's not too much. I don't think it's too much any other time, actually. But it's a beautiful, beautiful red. I need to pull my jacket up now. Ooh. But yes, very beautiful. This is Ruby Woo. It's my first time buying it. I bought it, like, a week ago. Loving it. Other color is a Rebel. Highly recommended color as well from everyone on YouTube. Anyone who loves a bold lip. Perfect for fall. I've been eyeing this color for, like, a year. And I finally got myself to buy it. It's very scary in the tube. It looks like a dark, grungy purple, but it's not. It comes off so beautiful. That is, see, it looks completely different, right? Beautiful. I wore it in a recent video. What video was it? It was my giveaway, my clutch giveaway, as well as my Michael Todd review, the moisturizer review. I wore them in both of those videos. And I wore Ruby Woo in my little black bag review video. Definitely check those out if you want to see it on. So those are my September favorites. Now, to talk a little bit about why I'm going to LA. I'm leaving for LA in 9 days. I'm leaving, like, on the 13th. It's a Saturday. Not this Saturday, but next Saturday. I'm going out for a couple days, but more specifically, I'm coming out for an event that you guys are all invited to if you want to go, if you're in Southern California. It's hosted by Holler Deals, and they're having a runway show for their local socialite clothing line that they have. The Holler Deal gurus, me being one of them, will be walking the runway. Yeah. So if you guys want to come see all of us and check out the local socialite collection, I will put the information and invitation down below. You have to RSVP by emailing somebody, so check that out in the info box. Thank you guys, as always, for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed seeing all of my favorites and hearing about them. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video.